Well, here we are to have a look at a piece of history. This is a Watkins Rapier. Yes, the British Strat, dating from the early 60s. This is the model 33 indicating. It's got three pickups on it. There was a 22 which had two pickups, and there was a 44. Yes, so this is the 33, the middle one. Now, as you can see, it's not in original condition, because originally it would have been red or blue or white or whatever colour they were, but some budding artist has decorated this with a very pleasing dragon. If you're into dragons, it's a very nice dragon. On the back of the guitar, turning the door carefully. There's something up in this corner which I'm not quite sure. Seaweed is my main guess, and there's a wee French cross down on the bottom there. You probably won't be able to see it, but there is. If I can get the light on it, don't think I can. There's a kind of a Grim Reaper figure carved into the back as well. Yes, and artistic as these things are, of course, they've. I would reckon that's the value of the guitar gone. But there again, we do these things when we're young, don't we? Somebody probably did this a long, long time ago, never thinking that it would the guitar would one day be valuable. I actually met a man once who junked a Steinway piano. If you don't know anything about pianos, that's like throwing away 20 grand or so, you know. So, this is minor in comparison to that. What does it sound like? Right, dig into the pocket and see if we can find a plectrum. There we can. The red plaque. There we go. Plenty of sustain on the instrument. Now you're hearing it just through the Zoom recording desk with a wee bit of reverb popped onto it, and that's it. That's all, and it's got plenty of tone. Now, although the guitar is well battered, the electronics are absolutely perfect. 50 odd years down the road, and they're absolutely spot on. There's not a crackle or anything going on in there that shouldn't be. But the control panel is somewhat confusing, to say the least. Now, we've got a two-way toggle switch here, and down here, two little on-off switches, and then three knobs. What do they all do? Well, the toggle switch is at the moment allowing us to hear the middle pickup. So this is what we're on just now. If I throw that back, then I'm onto the neck and the bridge pickups. And that's what these wee switches are for. Oh. So together they sound. So, very nice indeed. If I kill the black one, that's the neck pickup on its own. The neck pickup. But that was the forward one. Yeah, right. And if I kill the red one, you can hear we're on the bridge pickup, both down together. It was so confusing, actually, I had to write it all down and get wee notes. Now, the volumes, you've got two volume controls and a tone control. And the front one here is for, yeah, the bridge and the neck pickup. And away it goes. The middle one is for the middle pickup. Hear that? You'll note no crackling. And the tone control is actually for the neck pickup alone. It doesn't seem to work on anything else. So if I pop back to that. Fiddle with it. Very nice indeed. The build quality is not what we're used to nowadays. We've been spoiled. The fingerboard is a bit uneven. The position markers, well, some of them are flush and some of them are kind of concaved in a wee bit. You know, it's not the sort of thing that Mr. Yamaha would approve of. But there again, back in those days, anything that looked like a guitar sold. Although I wasn't actually working in shops, I'm not that old. When this was made, I was about 10. So, and dreaming of these things. So that's it. Now, what does it sound like with a wee bit of distortion? I'm doing a little lead stuff on it. Distortion, of course, is the modern idea. When this was new, the last thing guitarists wanted was distortion. If you got a distorted sound out your amplifier, you took it back to the shop and you complained. Sad but true. How times change. Isn't that Mr. Hendrix? Oh, what a terrible man. Terrible man. Anyway, here we go. There you go. What's it sound like up the top?